jump at you.
That was pretty good, Shorty.
Being big is for losers. Big losers.
Don't overdo it, Rose.
Yeah.
Rising sand!
Let's do this!
Awake, it's better!
Hang on! Let it down!
Is this the new hideout?
One of the candidates. I'll go check it out. Wanna come?
I'm gonna take a look. Sorry, but wait here a sec. What? The Mabo curry bun was a huge success!
It might become the Sparrow Feather's most famous product at this rate.
Here's a sample. When you think Mabo curry bun, think Sparrow Feathers.
Thank you. That was a conversation with an Assassin's Guild.
Isn't it good that they're so peaceful?
It seems ideal for hiding away, but if we were attacked here, we'd be in a bind.
You're right. Well, that's that. Let's look somewhere else.
Sorry for making you all wait.
Boss, Talfrin's back.
Oh, how'd it go?
Well, the Mabo curry bun was super popular, and...
The Romano firm looks legit on paper, but it's about as shady as it gets.
More than 30 reported bankrupt families. The firm confiscates all the family's property and takes it as their own. And as for what happens to those broken families, well, take a guess.
There's gotta be a legal pitfall somewhere. Egil.
Have squads 2 and 4 back up Talfrin. Investigate the Romano firm and its surroundings.
Yes, sir.
I'll leave it up to you.
Even humans can make themselves disappear.
All right then, let's get going.
Sure.
That's my rose.
You scattered bones sure are on the same wavelength.
You think? Well, we are kinda like family.
Family, huh?
I wanted to ask you if someone named Brad was your father.
You mean our late leader? He's the one who saved me.
Oh, really?
Apparently, I was lost and roaming around the northern battlefield when he found me.
Just like me.
Seraphim don't have parents either.
You guys too, huh?
But we do know what it means to have a family.
Gramps was the one who raised both of us.
Same here. My friends in the Scattered Bones are like family to me, who took the same path I did.
You don't mind having to be an assassin?
No way! I'm grateful for it. It's better than us all being apart.
I see.
So, she doesn't mind, huh?
See? I told you the Mabo curry bun would be a huge hit.
Yeah, it's delicious.
Hey, mind your manners, you two.
But we gotta eat it before it gets cold.
Yeah, that'd be gross.
I can't take it anymore. Give me a bite.
Yeah, sharing is caring.
Your manners, everyone, please!
You want some too?
Yes, please! Oh!
Armadillos? But this one's so big.
You mean like Hellion size?
I want to get it! Shatterfang! 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 Yeah! Water! Water!
Don't slap on the fence!
Okay. Safe arrow! Breakdown! Not yet! No! Burst! Ocean flinch! Open the floodgates! Bottle arrow! Open the floodgates!
Uncalled
wall! Burst! Burst!
Sweet dreams!
This isn't over!
Unleash your hidden power! It's you! Yeah. You are next!
It's the light double
weapon! You're gone! Yeah! How's this?
Resilient aim!
Shatterfang!
That was pretty good, Shorty.
Being big is for losers. Big losers.
Retreat and emit sonic waves.
Three strikes and you're out. Hook, strong back.
Everyone okay? quite strong.
We won't be defeated!
Dragon Fang! It's over! Multiple times! It's over!
Ready?
I won't lose!
Everyone, multiple currents.
Let's keep it up.
It's over.
Like we've been going.
Water, water.
Don't fight on defense.
Ray going through.
Yeah.
Blue flurry.
Over the budget.
Bubble arrow.
Burst.
Breakdown.
That's your assault.
Four.
Look
back again.
Don't let up.
Focus on defense.
From the
blue flurry.
Over the budget.
Focus on efforts.
Alright! Blue Flurry!
Alright!
Say zero! Here it comes! Here it comes!
This doesn't look good!
Burst! Aim and fire! Burst!
Alright!
Last one!
Burst!
Say zero! Aim and fire!
Hey, it wasn't that easy.
That was a cinch.
It was a little easier than that.
Then what was it?
A piece of cinch?
How's this for a start?
Weapons ready!
Tiger Blade! It's time! Howling Blade!
Focus on all three protection
hits! You are
dead!
Keep going! Yeah! It's over! Ready? It's over! Who's dropping low?
Burst!
Open the floodgates! Bubble arrow! Break on through! Defensive maneuvers!
Break
down!
Let's armatize!
Let's spread out! Blue flurry!
Right!
Blue flurry!
Release my spear!
Aim and fire!
Sweet dreams!
Aim and fire!
This one's tough. Don't slack on defense.
Say zero.
Here it goes.
Aim and fire.
Ocean flint.
Let's do it.
Aim and fire.
Ocean flint.
Unleash your wind.
Open the floodgates. Bubble arrow. Blue flurry.
Burst.
Blue flurry.
What a formidable opponent!
this have happened?
Ready, everyone?
Yeah!
Looks like we win.
Enemy spotted.
How's this?
What a cool weapon! Think I could use it too?
You can try, but don't get carried away with it.
You were just waiting for me to pick you up, weren't you?
Thank you.
steady your nerves.
Yeah!
It's an orc farmer. This hellion used to be...
I can guess, and I'd rather not know anyways. Thanks.
That's more like it.
Sorta, I'm ready.
Yeah!
It appears we're going to get skunked.
You sure seem persistent.
Yeah!
This isn't over!
Right!
Open the floodgates!
Cover arrow! Break on through!
All right! Let's get him!
No escape!
Aim and fire! Open the floodgates! Cover arrow! Saint Zero! Breakdown!
Get locked!
Aim and fire! Breakdown!
That's the way!
Here it comes! Aim and fire! Here it comes!
I showed them!
Even out of the rain, it's still so cold.
I'll say.
Damn.
They've gone from scary to annoying.
Still, to think Seraphim Smooth is just like you.
Ready? Let's get up!
How's this?
Yeah!
Who's rubber
rain? Don't
let them
think!
Ocean flex!
Open the floodgates!
Bubble arrow! Ocean flex!
Open the floodgates! Cover arrow! Aim and fire!
Ocean flex!
Alright! Saint Zero!
Release my capacity!
You won't in here! I won't lose!
Unleash your wind power!
You won't in here!
Lord of Wind!
To the front!
Unleash your wind power!
Strike! Here goes!
Go!
Here go!
Fear my wind!
Strike! Dragon Blade! Here goes!
Fear my wind!
Final protection dragon!
Put some thought into it! Put some thought into it!
Come forth!
Gale back
up! Fear my shot! Come forth!
Gale back up!
Come on, everyone! Wind flip dragon
blitz! Look here, my wings!
Right!
Eyes on the prize!
Dragon, look here, my
stars!
You're gone! You won't in here! You won't in here!
Do our best!
Gather,
eyes on the prize!
Yeah,
do our best!
Barrier!
Eyes
on
the prize!
Yeah!
Ready for protection!
I will smite evil! Tiger Blade! Ready, Gale! Ready, Gale! All right!
Eyes on the prize barrier!
Earthborn! Revision Giant, that won't work!
Warp instantly.
Rising Sand!
Dry up!
Sorta, is your sword style self-taught?
Yep.
Your grip, swing, and focus need work. But otherwise, it's okay.
Is that a compliment?
Of course not.
No, it is.
Huh?
Whoa. This place is huge.
Yes. Pendrago is the largest city on the Glenwood continent.
Where can we find an inn?
I reckon.
He's one of the Cardinal's subordinates. I tried to apprehend him, but you saw what he was like.
His movements were incredible.
You could tell, right? It was a Hellion.
The Cardinal's underling is a Hellion? Then...
Forgive me, sir. He's escaped into the Shrine Church.
It looks like it's true.
I believe he was likely a messenger of-
I'm cold. You can blather on inside.
Achoo!
Tell us the details after we find shelter from the rain, if you please. Our friends are feeling a bit chilly, and even a seraph can catch a cold.
Friends?
Not that you could tell, since you can't see him.
Forgive me. I should have been mindful of the Seraphim's presence. Let us head for the Knight's Tower.
Your wife sure is considerate.
Yep.
He still thinks they're married.
Thank you.
This should be a better place to talk.
Did everything go okay? Can we get in the church?
I secured the permissions, but after that last incident, I'm afraid we're likely under high scrutiny.
So what else is new? They weren't big fans of us in the first place.
Yeah, good point. We've got nothing to hide. Let's do it.
Look at that. Ever since Rose joined up with us, I feel like Saray has become so much more proactive.
Too bad it means that much more trouble for us.
Thank you.
It was my decision to begin with. And besides, I've really wanted to see the shrine inside the church.
There's something about you that reminds me of the Pope. He too would never hesitate to spare expenses for the sake of his people.
Oh boy, another masochist.
I see.
I've prepared lodgings for you. I pray that the Seraphim will also be able to rest well tonight.
But Captain, it's been 3 days since last we heard from Boris after his infiltration. I believe we should hurry.
Who's Boris?
The rain may be affecting our food supplies, but I shall prepare our famous Drago stew for you.
Aren't you the least bit concerned? He's your only brother.
I do not wish to burden you with my troubles any more than I already have. Please rest for now.
It's a kind offer. Let's take it.
We will. Thank you. Sergei sure seems like a good guy.
He is, though I fear he may be a bit too genuine and sincere to command the Knights.
I agree. I hope he has what it takes.
We've got plenty of worries of our own. Let's not get hung up on other people's issues.
A meal.
Hey, learn some manners.
You sure can eat.
So can these two.
It was surprisingly good. I couldn't help myself.
Drago stew, 85 points.
My policy is eat while you can. It's been ingrained in me since I was a kid. That's the law of a soldier.
A soldier, huh?
Soldier? Aren't you and your buddies in an assassin's guild?
Well, you know, it wasn't always like this. We used to be just a band of mercenaries. Not to brag, but they called us the best on the continent.
Is that right?
That's it for me. We've got a job to do tomorrow.
Is Rose's band of mercenaries the one you mentioned before?
The Windriders, I believe.
I think I've heard of them. The tale said just 100 of them could scatter a force of 20,000 men and capture 3 castles in one night.
Yeah, they were a legendary band of mercenaries. It's no wonder Rollins itself was their primary employer.
They sound crazy strong.
Strong and loyal. To the point that even the Emperor of Rollins trusted them like his right-hand man. Isn't that right?
It's true. Was true. But then, the Imperial family of Rollins ended up stabbing them in the back, along with the very one I'm seeking vengeance against.
The Imperial family joined forces with Hellions?
Is it that surprising?
I guess not. People and Hellions aren't separate entities, after all.
Very true. You can even consider them two sides of the same coin.
In fact, if the Cardinal's power is somehow linked to a Hellion, things start to make sense.
It looks like Rose snuck out through the back. Can't take my eyes off her for a second.
Hey, Dazzle!
I wonder if someone ordered an assassination.
Who? And was she asked to do it by herself?
Either way, this is bad.
What's wrong? Why are you all here?
That's what we want to know. Where were you going?
Oh, just taking a walk. Thought maybe I ate too much.
You don't have to follow every whim that pops into your head, dammit.
We thought you might have ditched us to go assassinate someone.
Not yet, silly. That comes later. It's from someone who lost their son in the war that just broke out. Kill the one who started the battle. The invasion was proposed to the Emperor about a year ago, in documents bearing the name of Pope Misedra.
Huh? You're gonna kill the Pope?
Hold on. How do you know someone didn't just use his name? I thought he went missing after all.
Maybe. But then again, maybe not. It's awfully close to the time you went missing. We'll have to investigate further.
And what if we find out that he's bad?
If it's evil, the scattered bones slay it.
Even if it's the Pope?
The Pope, the Emperor, even the Shepherd. Oh, was that inappropriate?
I'm not a fan of that last part, it's true.
It isn't like we walk around all stabby-stabby. We make sure what kind of person our target is first.
I think I understand you better, Rose.
Do you now? Well, that's good.
I'm starting to understand, too. Why she bears no malevolence, that is.
Because she's as nuts as he is?
Rose would certainly never tell a lie, that's for sure.
She was always that way. It's in her blood.
Was the Pope the type of person who would just up and start a war?
That's certainly not the impression of him we got from Sergei.
He's the de facto leader of a powerful country. He's probably got more layers than you'd think.
Yeah.
Well, that was easier than we thought.
This looks like an auditorium of sorts for the believers.
Sure looks like a...
Can you tell me the names of the seraphim who hold the utmost power, known as the Five Lords?
Musif! Oh, and Eumacia!
Hyanawa and Almanach!
Correct. Now, can you tell me the name of the last one? The seraph who's worshipped here at the Shrine Church?
Motelis!
That's right! Motelis is the seraph who has given the entire Glenwood continent his blessing.
The seraph worshipped at the Shrine Church is Motelis?
The Five Lords, huh? Big movers and shakers.
I bet Motelis would know something about how to stand against the Lord of Calamity. He's got to!
Is he really all that?
Well, he's the leader of the Five Lords, after all.
You must be Sore. Welcome to the Roland's Church headquarters. I heard you were to visit. Please, come on in.
It's more magnificent than I'd even imagined.
The architecture definitely dates it to the height of the era of Asgard.
Glad to see you're impressed, but don't let your guard down.
This inscription concerns the trial of the Shepherd, and the spiritual powers he obtains upon clearing it.
Could the spiritual powers
be real?
Bzz, 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 bzz.
Be real, real bees. Oh, bees everywhere.
Just possibly. It's like the lettering's meant to tell us something.
But it's all gibberish. It must be some kind of code.
Well, it does involve sensitive info. Maybe there's a hint to crack the code somewhere.
Hey, what does the big rock thing say?
I'm afraid I'm not really sure. The inscription is written in some sort of cipher, and the key to interpreting it is handed down only from Pope to Pope.
So, I guess we'll have to get the Pope to read it then, huh? Something's wrong. Let's get out of here.
I don't feel so good. What is going on?
It's a Hellion's domain. Just like when we fought Heldolf.
Going home already, Shepherd?
Huh?
I am Cardinal Fortin of the Church of Roland's.
This domain, is it yours?
Ah, so you can still move. Why don't you lend me your powers? For the sake of the people, of course.
They asked me the same thing in Highland.
I hardly think myself the equal of a Philistine like Bartlow.
Sounds like something a Philistine would say.
Charming, but sticks and stones and so on, young lady.
Ooh, she's good.
I have but one wish, to see my empire overcome this tumultuous era of chaos. A task only possible if the people are united. But Roland's is far too expansive to unify the people through mere patriotism alone. Shepherd, do you know exactly what it is that the state has used for eons to keep an entire country in line?
Is it faith?
Yes, faith. It is the belief in their own salvation that inspires in people the greatest sense of unity. When they band together against outsiders who share different values. Meaning that my church itself should serve as the cornerstone for all of Roland's.
Maybe in your mind.
It is but the vision of one who would guide the people. With the name and power of the Shepherd, more people than ever can be brought to salvation.
Then you should cooperate with the Knights. Wouldn't that really be what's best for everyone?
I would welcome their efforts if they would simply bend to my will and do as I command. Even if they are a pack of loutish meatheads who can't figure out that their Pope abandoned them.
Wait a minute, the Pope just ran away? You didn't have him locked up?
I am not a street thug, child. The Pope, Mesedra, I should say, left of his own accord. Abandoning his duty to both the Empire and his followers. What, pray tell, would you call such a man?
Pretty irresponsible, if what you're saying is true.
Irresponsible is one word, and still there are so many fools out there who trust in such a coward. The Knights, for example. In order to bring the people together, we must find Mesedra and give him his due punishment.
Punishment?
Yes, the same punishment that befell those uncivil enough to mistrust me.
Then we have a problem. We need the Pope to tell us the meaning of the inscription.
Why? Cooperate with me and it won't be necessary.
I need to know. No matter what.
Ah, I see. That's very unfortunate. So then you mean to say...
What the...
My body!
That you reject my vision!
Saray! Let's go!
We're leaving.
What? They broke through my domain and connected with the Seraphim, if only just for a moment. Oh, will I relish this?
We disappeared? What the hell was that?
It's called the Spectral Cloak.
You've been practicing in secret, haven't you? That was sweet!
We'll talk later. We've got to flee to the Knight's Tower.
You go on ahead.
Okay.
The Pope fled of his own volition?
I'm sorry I couldn't get more details. We were sort of running for our lives.
No, that is more than enough. I'm just relieved that you weren't captured.
Thanks for saving us back there.
It's the least I could do.
Seraph Miklio, my humble admiration for your bravery.
It's nothing, really.
It is nothing. All you did was blind her temporarily.
We have to do something about her domain.
Those powers might help. Let's get the Pope to decipher that inscription.
That'll be tough if we don't know where he is. The Knights have been hunting him for a year now with no success.
Yeah, but they were assuming the whole time that the Cardinal was behind the disappearance. Guess what? I think I know where Popodope might be.
You do?
The village of Gadadin on the southern part of the continent. We won't know for sure until we check it out, of course.
How did you get that information?
Well, let's just call it an industry secret. You know how it is.
Of course. I should have expected no less from the wife of the shepherd. Let us send a search team to Gadadin.
Hold on a minute. The Cardinal already expects that our side will be searching for the Pope.
A highly visible squadron of knights would essentially be a bright pink arrow pointed straight at him.
However,
we can operate covertly in small numbers. Let us handle Gadadin.
But that's far too much to ask.
Chill, Cap'n, we got this. What is it they say? Pope springs eternal?
Abandon Pope! All ye who, don't go to Gadadin.
Okay, settle down.
My thanks, gentle shepherd.
Actually, as for what you can do in return, do you suppose we could get a pass to Roland's? I might be mistaken for an ally of the Highland Army otherwise.
I have seen for myself the quality of your character. I shall prepare it immediately.
Thank you. That's a load off my mind.
There is something I would like to impart to you as well. Would you please step outside for a moment? Do you remember the art I used when we fought against one another? That is the Lion's Howl, an art passed down through our band of knights. I and my younger brother Boris are the only ones alive who know it. But now I pass it to you as well. Wilt thou accept?
Yes.
Fast learner. I must apologize that this feeble art is all an oaf like me may offer you.
Don't say that. It's incredible. Thank you so much, Captain Sergei.
You and I stand as equals. You may call me Sergei.
Then you may call me Sarai.
Sarai, I am loath to believe the Pope just abandoned his post on us. But I also sense that there may be another side to this unfortunate story.
I understand. We'll find the Pope and come back with the truth.
Godspeed.
Rose. Was it the Scattered Bones who found the information on the Pope?
Maybe. Seeing where the church's money was going gave us a little hint.
That's what I thought. You guys sure don't operate in the same way that the knights do.
Course not! An Assassin's Guild can't function without proper intel.
Assassins, right.
Here is your pass, Sarai.
Thank you. Our travel should be much easier now.
I wish it were so, but we've received word that Byrocliff Ridge, which leads to Gadadin, has been blocked by rock slides.
We could have been on the ridge right now.
If only we'd been a little bolder.
Rose! My punchline!
What's the plan?
You'll have to go through Cambria Caverns. South of the Meadow of Triumph.
An underground passage, huh? No problem!
That's your thing, isn't it?
You bet it is!
Gotcha, Gold.
Sure looks like the Cardinal's a Hellion.
Indeed. Though we have yet to discover its true form.
In other words, she claims to be serving the people, but in reality, she's just furthering her own ambitions.
Sounds about right, stupid humans.
Perhaps she was burdened with a responsibility she could not bear. The pressure to do something, anything, most likely was channeled into her sense of self-justification.
So basically she couldn't hack it. Do you think the Pope jumping ship might have been what finally set her off?
That I couldn't tell you.
Your, job kinda depends on that, right?
Yep. That's why I gotta track down this Pope and see for myself just what kind of person he is.
Saray, you must gain the spiritual powers. Everything else comes second.
Right. Let's try and find the Pope.
Go, go, Gadadin! I ate too much today. My stomach's all achy.
Oh my, you shouldn't stuff yourself like that, Rose.
By the way, I was curious. Can Seraphim get upset stomachs or gain weight?
To say it in a fairy tale sort of way, your thoughts become reality.
What's that supposed to mean?
We won't gain weight from consuming calories, but we will from thinking, I'll gain weight if I eat this much.
Whoa! So does that mean you'll be okay as long as you don't think like that?
No. Denying the reality of things leads to malevolence. A seraph must not be detached from reality. So at the end of it all, you could say we're the same as humans.
This is so confusing!